What's up, folks? Man Amazing here, and welcome back to the channel. So with Lumberyard still being a moderately new engine, a lot of folks are diving in, trying to figure out how things work, testing samples, hopefully using my tutorials, and trying to see if the engine is good for them. So I figured it would be good to start doing small videos on tips and tricks and settings that you might not know about. So the first thing is going to be getting and setting your variables in a more easier manner. So when you create a variable, you drag it into the graph, and then you have an option to either get or set the variable. We can actually cut out that middleman, and when you hold shift and drag the variable, it automatically gets it. Conversely, if you hold alt and drag it, it sets the variable. The next thing is actually configuring your editor panels for customizable layouts. This allows you to take almost any editor and to dock it. You can tab it by placing it on the middle icon. You can place it on the left, the top, the bottom, or the right side of another editor tab. There are many different configurations, as well as very many places to place any editor. Play around with it and see what you come up with. The next tip is unlocking uniform scale. To find this option, with your object selected, at the very bottom of the editor, you will see a lock scale option. Uncheck that to where it's not highlighted in that orange glow. Once you do that, you will then have the option to affect each axis individually. The next tip is accessing your global preferences inside of the editor. This will have very many options to do certain things like disabling source control or checking up on the many features that are experimental, such as the UI, just to kind of see where Lumberyard is heading and what they're messing with. Though I don't recommend enabling this right now because it's kind of hit or miss. More often than not, if you do enable it, you're going to kind of break the engine. So yeah, placing this here for more of a reference than a go ahead and try it. Last but not least is being able to set a default map when exporting your game. When exporting your level, you're hit with a black screen when the game is started up. And you're forced to actually open up the tilde key, type map, space, in your level name to start the level. To combat that, what you want to do is go to your root folder of your project, find the file autoexec.cfg, open it with any text editor, and inside this we want to type map space in your level name. So go ahead and save that, close it, and reopen your project. You should now get your level loaded by default. There you go. 5 tips in the Lumberyard game engine that I think you guys should know. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys want more tips, let me know. If there are some things that you guys have found out over your time using the engine, post it in the comments below. Other than that, hope you guys are having a very dope day. Don't forget to join the Discord. You guys can talk to me personally, pretty much up at all hours of the day. I try to respond when I'm at work, but we're a slowly growing community that I'm hoping to get bigger, especially going into the new year. Other than that, hope you guys are having a very dope day. Hope you guys are prospering in your projects. And until next time, keep developing.